kind of a titanic Little League World Series match, given how good Louisiana has been this summer. They haven't lost, and the reputation Hawaii brings in here, basically winning, well, the last four times they've been here. And they've taken three overall titles, so this should be a good game. Images from today, we started out with team from Virginia getting a two-run shot from Brady Yates late in the game, and a combined no-hitter, Dave.
Well, I mean, he looked so good. That was a beautiful start to our day.
And South Korea exploded on the Volunteer Stadium. They took down Venezuela, double-digit runs for them. And then how about the team from Coon Rapids, Minnesota? We saw Minnesota eke out a 2-1 win. They committed four errors. Jameson Kuzmia was great, but a couple of SportsCenter top 10 web gem type plays, especially from their shortstop, who was crazy. Last name, Knutson. Get to know it. Virginia 3-0, Minnesota 2-1. Look out, Japan over Italy in the top of the fifth, so that one will end in the fifth inning. They get a 19-run lead. Yikes, Mexico and Canada set to start roughly an hour from now on ESPN News. We got one more after this. It's New Jersey and Oregon at 7 o'clock Eastern time. Kind of a bold day. We set the old table with seven games, and it looks like we're going to be able to get them all in. This is game three for Rossi and Ravitch here. Jess Mendoza will join us for the 7 o'clock game. It's been great. I mean, the atmosphere, the play has been outstanding. And now you got two really good teams here, Hawaii and Louisiana. Should be a terrific baseball game.
Yeah, I've been looking forward to this game all day. I mean, this is the one we've had circle on our map. These two teams, great matchup, great pitching. You got the defending champs in Hawaii against a team that hadn't been here before, Louisiana. Really fired up for today.
All right, Marshall Luke is the name to remember. He's going to be on the mound for this team from Louisiana. His hobbies are hunting and fishing. What he does, though, on a baseball field is pretty special, both with his arm and with his bat.
Well, he's got a better hobby than that. It's called punishing baseballs and striking guys out. This kid is a cool customer, according to his coach, Scott Frazier. He has it, the best he's ever seen in his 20 years. He can hit, he can run the bases, he can pitch. This guy is their stud. They're going to need him to be big. Special, special kid. Learn his name.
Inspired by his brother, whose story we'll get into a little bit later on. Meantime, Hawaii, I mentioned it. It may be reputation, but there's clearly something to it. Whatever island you come from, you come here to Williamsport and you win. We saw it with Honolulu last year. In 2005, the Eva Beach team from Hawaii, Little League World Series champions. 2008, Waipahu, World Series champions. And of course, last year, the great team from Honolulu, World Series champions. You can play baseball pretty much year-round in Hawaii, but Maui and, of course, their mayor is Shane Victorino's dad, and Shane Victorino has reached out. This is a gritty group. They don't hit the ball over the wall all the time, but Julie, the expectations are very high.
All right, Coach, with all the success of Hawaii over the years, this is actually the first team from Maui to make it to the Little League World Series. How special is that for your group?
It's super special for our group. We're really excited to be here and just mix it up with the best teams here.
Is it extra pressure, extra motivation with the success these Hawaii teams have had? They've won three Little League World Series titles since 2005.
No pressure at all. We feel that we're the underdogs. So we have nothing to lose, everything to gain. We just want to come out here and play good baseball and see where it falls.
Coach, I don't know if Hawaii is ever the underdogs, by the way. What do you love most about this group?
I love most about this group is they're just a brotherhood. You know, they've gelled together well. Everybody's got each other's back, and they play with their hearts, you know, and they're always in the game, and they always stay focused.
Best of luck with your first game.
Thank you very much. God bless.
Thank you, sir. And they came out of a tough region. Southern California they beat. They beat Arizona. They beat Northern California. They beat Arizona again. Unbeaten. 4-0 in a West Regional, which may be the most difficult to emerge from. 21 questions as we head to break.
And there's rice and watermelon.
Thank you.
Yeah, have a good afternoon.
Hey, Logan, what do you like on your pizza?
Pepperoni.
Shaved ice or ice cream?
Ice cream.
What is your favorite part about Williamsport?
Playing baseball.
Mike Trout or Christian Yelich?
Mike Trout.
Would you rather hit a walk-off or pitch a no-hitter?
Walk-off.
What's your favorite part about your team?
Brotherhood.
Awesome. Time for any more questions?
No, I gotta eat.
All right, thank you.
A lot of smiles on the faces of the kids, the fans, the coaches, the families, the managers as well. There you go. Foudy's going to practice that. A little worm in the background. That's happening. East Bank Little League is here. This was a little league that's been in existence for less than 10 years. It's around 9 miles west of the French Quarter, 11 miles from downtown New Orleans, located in Jefferson Parish. Louis Armstrong, Steve Scalise, a couple of the notable people from that area. And now it's time to meet the boys that'll be stepping to the plate. Today's team lineup presented by the Office Depot.
My name is Alan Schwartz, and my favorite subject is social studies.
My name is Ryder Blanchard, and my favorite player is Derek Jeter.
My name is Stan Wills, and my favorite baseball player is Jose Altuve.
My name is William Andrade, and my favorite app is ESPN.
My name is Payne Spadoni, and my favorite athlete is Drew Brees.
My name is Derek Dillat, and my favorite emoji is the sunglasses.
My name is Connor Farrell, and my favorite baseball player is Bryce Harper.
My name is Ryan Dara, and my favorite food is steak.
My name is Jeffrey Curtis, and my favorite baseball player is Aaron Judge.
My name is Gavin Berry, and my favorite food is hamburgers.
My name is Reese Roussel, and my favorite baseball player is Alex Bregman.
My name is Marshall Luke, and my favorite emoji is the muscle one.
My name is Egan Prather, and my favorite actor is Adam Sandler.
Ryan Darrow leads things off. He's a big kid. Louisiana's got a big team, and Scott Frazier is the guy behind the whole team. He started this little league around 6 years ago. They didn't have one in New Orleans. It was either Dixie Youth or Babe Ruth. He wanted to provide an opportunity to the community to get into Little League, and he's got two daughters. So, of course, he was asked why you do this. He said, my hobby is this. He's all into it, and this team has exceeded
Ryan,
a lot of the expectations they had.
Don't chase up.
He said he's had expectations about Williamsport, and they've been totally blown out of the water since he's been here.
Big Jaron Pasquale's on the mound for Hawaii. Throws a fastball, throws it up, and one of the last messages we just heard from the manager, Scott Frazier, to the first batter, Ryan Darrow, was lay off the stuff that's up. Long way from Boston, but that's his favorite team, the Red Sox.
Maybe because of Victorino.
Could be. First pitch swinging, popped up. Second baseman goes out there, and he gives way to the right fielder, Marley Sebastian.
Coming out swinging.
One pitch, one out.
A jump all over that fastball up. Just doesn't get on top of that one enough, but I like the mentality. Let's get this thing started.
Reese Roussel, you got to believe, too. There were butterflies. That one may have been up. He said lay off the stuff that's up, but come on.
Definitely some butterflies. Reese, the coach is telling me, he swings like a man. He does not get cheated, so let's watch this hack.
5'7", 131. Yeah, he takes a big hack. His nickname is 380 because he was getting into it with some other kids saying he hits 380-foot dingers, and his teammates heard it like, okay, 380.
Okay, 380, we feel you.
380's leaving 225 in the dust.
That's fine. Here we go, man. Here we go, Duke. Here we go, right behind you, Duke.
You hear the voice of Kelly Dine. She's calling balls and strikes tonight.
I love how she knows the catcher's name, Duke Aloy, back there. Already introduced herself, or him to her. Good relationship builder. I always did that to the umpire. Make sure you meet him and get this thing going from the get-go.
Fastball down the left field line. It is dropping. The dive and the catch is made. Logan Kulalea. What a start.
He had a beat on that, and that was tough. Left-handed hitter slicing away from him. Logan lays out, gets the glove out there. That would have been a fair ball. Nice play there by Logan, laying out. No regards for his body. Great job there by Logan, saving probably a double at least.
And Stefan Rohrbeck, our volunteer umpire, right there down that left field line. Here's one up the middle. That's fielded and then bobbled and too late on the throw. Branson Hogg did everything he did right, but he just couldn't get the ball in the glove.
Yeah, first play is always a little nervous. Tries to stay down, ball up the middle. Hops up just a little too much. Doesn't come up with it. And then after that, it's going to be too late with the speedy runner.
How about Louisiana coming out swinging, though, the team from East Bank. That's a good pitch. Fastball in there for a strike, and it was a hard one.
Jaron Pasquale throwing cheese.
Your guy's up, little nugget. Runner goes, and that's a good read by Luke, he took off.
Head coach talked about his baseball instincts. He does everything right. He has the it factor, and you see right there, first ball in the dirt. He's ready to go, long strides. He'll be on the mound for them today. He's the stud of this group.
So challenging right away for Duke Aloy to keep that ball close to him as the next one is delivered. That's a hard fastball, and it is down in the zone from Jaron Pasquale. Shallow one in the left. It's going to get down. Luke rounds third. And Louisiana is on the board. They lead it 1-0 and now heading into second. Perot is in there with a single and then some hesitation picking it up. Kulalea.
Nice swing here by Connor. Ball runs in on him a little bit, jams him just enough. But when you're inside the ball, good things happen. Nice little leg kick. Oh, it's off the end, actually. It gets a little sink down and in, stays on it just enough. Here, throws it out here to the left field, and then a nice heads-up base running. Bobbled in left by Logan. Trying to pick it up and throw him out at second base. Good heads-up base running.
So Louisiana scores the first run of the game, and we may have a special pinch runner. You can see the head coach of Louisiana looking into his dugout. They're kind of waiting for somebody to get a helmet on and get ready to run. And that's exactly the case. Peyton Spadoni's coming in as a special pinch runner. Gavin Berry is now at the plate.
This Louisiana team coming out swinging. They are tired of sitting around the Grove and hanging out. They want to play some baseball, and you can tell jumping on Jaron early on in this game.
Called strike one. This is an East Bank team that went through the Southeast Regional and put up some big numbers, winning against Arkansas 11-0, and then a couple of Texas teams. East they beat 4-1 and twice beat Texas West. Always a good team.
First time a Texas team hasn't been here in 7 years.
Center fielder calls it. Gets a little help from his right fielder, and the out is made by Caleb Mathias. Louisiana strikes first. Luke goes to the mound. He's got a 1-0 lead at the World Series. Couldn't ask for a better day here. South Williamsport, temperature in the mid-80s. Started with some haze and some fog, and it has cleared off beautifully. Hawaii, they know good weather. They're coming to the plate in the bottom of the first, trailing by a score of 1-0. Been to Maui several times. Great golf tournament out there. Once the Mercedes Championship name has changed, but that's where they start the PGA Tour season. The great Shane Victorino and Kurt Suzuki, notable people from the area. It is 3 miles west of the Kalui Airport. Let's meet the kids. It is brought to you by Office Depot.
My name is Marley Sebastian, and my favorite video game is Minecraft.
My name is Caleb Mathias, and my favorite food is pizza.
My name is Katie Miyake Matsubayashi, and my favorite baseball player is Doc Peterson.
Hi, my name is Isaac Kimomura, and my favorite emoji is a shock emoji.
My name is Nicholas Nashio, and my favorite singer is Bruno Mars.
My name is Nakea Kalahau. My favorite baseball player is Derek Jeter.
My name is Logan Kulaloa, and my favorite food is pancakes.
My name is Duke Aloy, and my favorite game is Fortnite.
My name is Shiloh Gilliland. My favorite athlete is Troy Polamalu.
My name is Caleb Chai, and my favorite baseball player is Jose Altuve.
My name is Jaron Pasquale, and my favorite actor is Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
My name is Branson Hong, and my favorite singer is Post Malone.
My name is Kamahao Akima, and my favorite subject is math.
We're back. He said this team is an underdog, bunch of grinders. I guess Victorino has kind of expressed the same thing to you too, right?
He's been blowing up my phone. He's watching. I know that. What's up, Shane? I know you're watching, locked into this game, pulling for this group. He is a big, so proud of being from Hawaii and his hometown, and really tight with this Little League group.
Central East Maui Little League, first Little League World Series, first time a Little League from Maui plays in the Little League World Series. Isaac Imamura will start things off, the second baseman, and Marshall Luke can just pump it.
Hard fastball up to 73 miles an hour, coming in hot for Marshall Luke. It is, get it ready, you better be locked in. Fastball, curveball, slider.
Here's a breaking ball. So we've seen the fastball, the breaking ball. Favorite player is Alex Bregman. You can understand why. A lot of folks love Javi Baez, Alex Bregman. They do tend to gravitate towards the younger Major League Baseball player, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And they it's all the swag that these young players got in the big leagues. Listen to these kids, what they wear, how they talk. They love to watch the players with a little flash and excitement. I think Javi Baez, Bregman's in that category. Some of the nice young Major League players that are just must-watch TV.
Luke has thrown three pitches. All of them have been strikes. Jam shot. That's his. One down.
A lot of tardy swings so far in this first at bat. Luke bringing the heat as we talked about. But this Hawaii team, as you see there, leading off there from Isaac. Great contact hitting team. No superstars on this team. They feel like as a collective group, they work well together. Going to put the ball in play. It's going to be tough today against Luke, but right there, you at least see a good at bat.
That one past the catcher is Branson Hong, the shortstop up here. His favorite team's the LA Dodgers. Good team to kind of have as your favorite right now.
Oh, man. I think they may be my favorite right now. They are a good, good team.
Juggernaut, he's been to Dodger Stadium a couple of times. Overthrew that one, and it goes to the backstop.
Really the first time we've seen a catcher set up inside on that last pitch. Luke just pulled it away, but looks like he's spotting up, trying to get to the corners already in this game.
Pours that one down the middle to go to 2-1. Branson's 5'4", weighs 118. He wants to be a physical therapist, like his uncle. Breaking ball gets a piece. Says anytime he would get hurt, his uncle would come over, and you kind of go a little deeper. He likes to swim. And he says he likes to swim because it develops his scapula muscle down the middle. And he just stares at that. You get that scapula muscle working, it can help you throw the baseball, Rossi.
Yeah, you need that deep back muscles to be strong. Keep that shoulder protected.
We're a division at a glance. We take a look at it. Division of Little League International, 16 teams that are here. 10 to 12-year-old boys and girls, six-inning game. You got a unit you're going to get into the game with a minimum mandatory play. Jaron Pasquale, first pitch, ball one. So pitcher against pitcher here.
It's funny how usually the top pitcher is usually the shortstop, and he's usually hitting in the three hole. It's usually where they move around. There's good players taking the bump here early on.
Jam shot past the second baseman into right field, and the first hit for Hawaii goes to Jaron Pasquale. Yeah, you're right. That is usually the case. Batting third or fourth. We got a little floss going. You were going to work on your floss.
I was going to, and I didn't do it this offseason. I was going to bring it here, break it out, but things kind of got in the way.
Left that?
Yeah, we left that in Tallahassee.
Shelf. The floss is in Tallahassee. All right.
That'll be another one for Jules. There she goes.
I think look at dude in the background. Look at him go.
Hey, that's Fortnite style. This is always a lot of dancing breaking out here at the Little League World Series, for sure.
Nicholas Nishiwa's gone on as a special pinch runner. It's a good job catching there by Egan Prather. Challenging when a guy throws that hard, isn't it?
I think that's going to be a key to this game. Defense, obviously, already has played a role. One error, one run. But you got to have a catcher that's not going to let the ball get by you. Catching's important. Can't give up extra bases when throwing errors or pass balls.
Mikea Kahalaho is at the plate looking at a 1-1 pitch.
That's a nice take there from Nakia.
Two balls, one strike.
Nasty slider.
Really see that Luke on the mound, his effort, keep that ball down. Another one down.
I like the approach here from the Hawaii team. If you're going to get to Marshall Luke, you're going to have to get his pitch count up. This guy bringing the heat, it's been their stud player. You're going to have to get his pitch count up and get him out of this game.
That's in there for a strike, 3-2. 5-6, 117 is Logan. He's on deck. Jam shot, third base. Blanchard, nope, no play. And all of a sudden, a mistake has Hawaii in business.
Ryder Blanchard had a good break on this ball. Just kind of a swinging bunt, a little bit charged it nicely, a jam shot, but just took his eye off the ball right at the last second. Just pulls that head up, feels like it's going to go right in and just overruns it, looking at that first base bag a little too early.
Now each team's made an error. The error cost Hawaii in the first. We'll see if Louisiana can avoid the damage. Strike one, Kamau Akimo, third baseman, before the game. Dugout goes out there. That's the mascot and dances. Akimo was the only guy from Hawaii that was moving. Ooh. He says hit him on the elbow. I think we'd have a bigger reaction than that.
Yeah, that speed, that definitely. He may have felt the breeze a little bit on that elbow. We're going to check it out, I think, anyways.
Kelly Dine, the home plate umpire. Let's see. Does it get the shirt?
Oh, make it that
back
elbow.
Did it change the direction a little bit there in the end?
Maybe. That back elbow. It's a tough kid.
Now, the way the catcher went after it, does it indicate that the ball wasn't where the catcher thought it was going to be?
Here we go. Let's see. Yeah, that's straight down. That hit him. That ball goes straight down.
So, I mean, the catcher kind of had his glove in one spot, and then Egan Prather watched it go in a different direction. So there's a good chance that Akimo is going to go to first, and we're going to have the bases loaded as Kelly Dine reviews it and says, yes, it's your base. So we are loaded now after a hit batter. In the first inning, Hawaii got a little threat here.
Other thing you got to remember here, the pitch count continues to grow when you got guys making errors.
Yep.
Getting more guys on, new batters rolling over that lineup. Gonna make it tough.
Base is loaded for Logan Kulaleo. Called strike one.
Cody Bellinger, favorite player. That's a good one to mimic.
Set up outside. Good rip at it, but he fouls it back. Now two strikes in the hole.
Oh, two, a lot of places to go. You can go in the dirt, but you got a guy on third. You got to have trust in your catcher, or you can go with the high heat up.
On the ground is short. Got the force at second. We throw across the diamond. Safe at first. Kulaleo beat it out. Not Stan Wilkes could either take it himself or flip it to second, but instead he went to first, and Kulaleo beat it out. We're tied.
Getting out of the box on this swinging ball to shortstop. Wilkes could have went to second nice and easily. Throws on the run, and just a speedy hitter. Yes, safe by a long shot. Probably should have went to second base on the flip there.
Yeah. Boy, Kulaleo flew down the first baseline, and he's aboard, and now still bases loaded in a 1-1 game for Duke Aloy. That ball gets by, and 2-1 Hawaii. Mistakes for Louisiana. Kahalu comes in and scores.
We talked about the errors kind of being a problem for the Hawaii team, costing them a run. The air
all right,
earlier
relax,
on.
Relax. Hey, how much we preach about one play, all right, that play's over with. Let's not waste any negative energy on what just happened, okay? So flush it all right? We're okay. We're going to score our runs. Everything's going to be fine, all right? So press reset, take a deep breath. Let's get back after it right here, okay? Everybody relax. Moving forward. Let's go.
Seven swings, seven contacts. So in spite of the speed of Luke, the team from Hawaii obviously not bothered by the velocity, and Duke Aloy's got a chance to add to that lead. Good message out there, though. I like that press reset. This is a long game. We're only in the first.
Well, I love the message of saying, hey, one at a time, and then knowing, hey, we're going to score runs. It's what we do. We can hit. We have confidence in our hitting ability to score some more runs. You don't want those crooked numbers to start creeping up there on that scoreboard.
Two strike, two out approach. Ooh, that didn't miss by much. Oh, Duke Deloy down the line. Just foul. Didn't miss by much.
It's one thing to listen to the coaches talk about our team as good contact hitters, but this Hawaiian team seems to get 0-2 and put the ball in play. These guys have good at-bats. When you talk about success at the big league level, those are the things I believe in. Great at-bats, contact, moving the baseball around. You're seeing that here from this Hawaii team in the first inning.
5'2", 115, another one to Duke Aloy. Breaking ball, that's high. Duke's taking a base a little prematurely. Good try, but only the good third
idea.
Ball.
Good idea.
Like where your head's at.
Contact, you just saw a third base coach. Brad Lung talking about, that's it, making contact, move the baseball.
A lot of pitches for Marshall Luke. He's thrown 30 here in the first inning. That one is into left field. It's going to get down. Akimo's going to score. Here's a throw home. It's way high. Two runs come in and more. Two out, two strike magic.
Duke Aloy again, this Hawaii group getting down in the count. Back-to-back 0-2 counts. Duke Aloy gets his fastball, middle, and what a beautiful swing. You see that back leg coming. Look at that. He's coming out of his shoes swinging this thing.
Hawaii with a four spot in the bottom of the first. For Marley Sebastian. Say this about Brad Lung, too. He was waving in Kulaleo without any hesitation when the left fielder had it. They were being aggressive on the base pass.
Watch him come out of his shoes right here. Look at that. That's a great swing. That's a picture perfect.
I love it.
Been there.
There's a strikeout from Luke. A good inning for Hawaii, and a lot of that damage done with two men out. Errors hurt you. 4-1 Hawaii through one.
They coming out of there. First time they haven't been in this Little League World Series.
You saw that number. They'd outscored their opponents 79-0. In the states and the district part of their tournament. Things got a little tougher in the regional, but they're down now 4-1. You can see a big daddy hack from Egan Prather, the catcher.
This is a group that can hit. They have confidence. You heard from their coach. Let's just settle down, make sure we don't give up too many runs early on. Slow things down, because we know we're going to hit and we know we're going to score.
I'll tell you one thing, we're warming up. We're getting hot on the top of that hill. Catcher's going after it. Oh, good effort there by Duke Aloy. How quick was he to respond?
That was a nice job of bouncing out there, trying to get down there as fast as you can. This is a tough one. The two-seamer here, and he bounces out of there quick. You want to get your body turned, but sometimes you don't have enough time. Duke Aloy there, nice play. That ball's got some fun, funky spin on it. That's a tough play for a catcher. Made it look really easy.
How good's the defense been on Lomity today?
It's been fun. We've had some great plays. I think Timmy Kirkson's already excited about Sunday's web gems.
Oh, yes. I am. We already got a couple of them. This is Derek Glatt. Not afraid to get some sushi in him at 5 foot, 101 pounds.
Fathead. Big old fathead. Good moss.
Aloy trying to convince home plate umpire Kelly Dine. That was in the zone.
Where is that? The other batter's box. No, I had it right on the corner.
This is a blooper, and it's going to drop in front of the center fielder, and Glatt reaches base with a single. Second hit for Louisiana. Here comes Smiley, Ryder Planchard. Travel ball coach for Ryder Planchard. May have heard of him, Ben Sheets.
Benny, I played with Benny. He's phenomenal. human being, great pitcher. I think he can still pitch. I've caught him 2 years ago. Still throwing that breaking ball.
Nasty breaking ball. He's good at curveball when he was at his height as you'd find.
It's part of his last outing in a Braves uniform went right before he retired. Struck out the side and just said, I'm done.
Shut it. Smiley, a nickname given to him by the head coach, Scott Frazier. He's been playing catcher since he was 8. The versatility of a lot of these kids playing multiple positions, so important, especially when one of them is a catcher. I know you fell in love with somebody today who was a pitcher, then he went to first, Lee, and then he went behind
Lee,
the plate.
Yeah, he's all over the place. I love it when they can play everywhere and they still choose to play some catcher. That's that makes my day.
In the dirt, how about Aloy with that block, with that runner at first base?
And that is textbook Aloy, blocking that ball, popping up and being ready in case that runner tries to go to second. That is cat-like reflexes.
Like that.
Like I never had.
2-2 to right field. That's up and it's playable. Nice job by Marley Sebastian. Outfield here at the Little League World Series this year, when you have no 13-year-olds, you're still using the newer bat, which doesn't have that spring effect that we're used to. Play a little shallower, and what used to be singles are now recorded as outs, a lot of them.
Yeah, we've seen a couple balls even get over there. The balls are hitting really hard that guys are playing shallow. They get over your head. Kids are around the bases pretty regularly. We're not going to see those bloopers fall in, how these outfielders are playing so shallow.
Instead of Stan Wiltz, who is scheduled to hit in the 9 spot, it's going to be Alton Schwartz. And this one to second base. It's knocked down. Still got time.
Wow.
Oh, nice job by Isaac Imamura. Knew how much time he had, Rossi. He knocked it down and fired a seed to first.
Watch how he knocks this ball down, how he scoops this ball trying to make it is why this is, ends up being an out for him. Gets his glove down there, almost gloves it, no panic, turns around, no tap, out at first. Nice play.
The left part of the screen, and you take a look at that west region, Arizona, has been very good. Typically Hawaii, obviously the California teams have been outstanding. And we congratulate the champions of their respective states. Home of Terry Francona, Tucson, Arizona. Little League champions there, Henderson, Nevada. Of course, Bryant and Bryce Harper's walk-off last night. You know about the youth baseball in Nevada. Roseville, California, they were the Northern California State Little League champions. Put up a really good fight. And it was an Arizona team that ultimately was the final victory for the team from Maui. Washington, Utah. Congratulations to the boys from Washington as they celebrate a Utah state title. And there is Hawaii out of Maui. Each of the last 4 Hawaiian teams to appear in the Little League World Series won the United States Championship. So that's what the powder blue and gold are up against. And they went 4-0 in those regionals. 11-1.
And they had to beat last year's champions from Honolulu to get here. I should say enough about how what a scrappy team was. If you watched last year, that team was a powerhouse.
That ball's driven to center field. Dara going back. It's over his head. It smacks up against the wall. And Mathias is into second with a stand-up double. Way to start it. That's their number 9 hitter, Caleb Mathias.
Great swing there by Caleb, staying on that ball to drive it to center. Great swings. We're talking about the contact. First 11 swings this Hawaii group has taken, they made contact, and they are 12 for 13 now when they swing the bat, making contact with the baseball.
And this, of course, is a really good strikeout pitcher, Marshall Luke, whose numbers at the regionals were crazy, and 11 plus 17 strikeouts. He's got 2 so far today. And Hawaii is doing just what it wants to get some runs and get that pitch count up. Isaac Imamura. Throw down behind the runner. And that Louisiana bullpen, you get a little action out there. who's out there warming up. William Andrade. Bunt foul. Good breaking ball that time, and Imamura is retired.
We'll see a couple more of those breaking balls from Luke this second time through the order. They were all over that fastball when he was trying to blow it by him. See here, just setting up in the other batter's box back there, Egan Prather. And that's how you get extension on that breaking ball. Nice pitch.
Ball one to Branson Hong, the 12-year-old, 5'4", 118. Nice catch back there by Prather one more time.
Surprised we didn't get a bunt there from Imamura.
Tried one, fouled it back. Once again, a Hawaii team, and this one comes in not as feeling like they're a favorite, but that they're an underdog. You think about the field they play on back in Maui, and you got to put a net up for the backstop. The live play, and if you miss the ball, it goes into a ditch, and they don't generally get it back.
I think that's why we've seen that great play from Duke Aloy already.
Yeah.
You've got to have a solid catcher when you've got a field with no backstop. Nothing can get by you. You guys are going to be running all over the place, especially you want to run back there and get it out of a ditch.
You've seen the ditches, some of the canyons in Hawaii? It can go deep on you.
There's that field, all dirt field. Huge backstop.
Three hitters, Jaron Pasquale. Chance with the runner at second. Wow, Prather just stabbed at that and was able to catch it. Pasquale, big guy, 5'7", 169.
Oh. Little Hunter Pence, like, hunched over in the box. Just that big back, standing on the dish, just raring to go. Nice wide stance. All he's got to do is pull those pants up above his knees. We'd see Hunter Pence on a little league field.
That one gets by, and now moving down to third base goes Mathias. So what are the challenges when somebody like Luke's on the mound throwing if you're the catcher?
Yeah, that was almost a front door breaking ball. Just kind of got a little close to the hitter. Prather lose sight of that.
You ever have Spam Musubi? That's a big delicacy over in Hawaii. Basically Spam and rice wrapped around some seaweed. That's what gets Pasquale to be about 5'7", 169.
Kind of a smart move right there. 3-1 breaking ball from Luke. Not giving in to one of their better hitters, Pasquale.
So 50 pitches, and perhaps they're going to take.
You start getting dressed, you take the stuff off, you're coming out.
Luke out of the game, they are.
It will. All right, we're going to hold off here on this pitch count stuff. Okay. Hey, there's gonna be more games to play in this sucker, right? All right, more games to play. Hey, positive attitude, because the bottom line is we're still only down by 3 runs. That's it. It's just 3 runs. After all of this, we're still only down by 3 runs. At the end of the day, we're gonna score 3 more runs. All right. So we got to stay positive. We're good. All right. Heads up. Hey, head up. Let's go. All right. So you're gonna go to third. Plant is going to catch. All right.
All right, Egan Prather's going to take the uni off. So, Rossi, I need you to shed the catcher gear. You're coming into pitch, son.
That's a lot of work. That's a lot of work.
Pravich, Julie Foudy, New Jersey and Oregon coming up at 7 Eastern time on ESPN. He's become somewhat of a legend in New Jersey, especially around Elizabeth, where this team is from. That's Yadi Mateo. Big dude. Good chance he's on the mound tonight for New Jersey. And when they get to second base, Rossi, or any base after a hit, you'll see a little shimmy. You get a little action going on the base pass with a little dance, a little celebration. Not afraid to show it.
I like a little celebration in the game. It makes it fun.
Right now, it's Hawaii 4, Louisiana 1, Japan, yikes. Mexico and Canada starting at 5 o'clock Eastern Time on ESPN News about 10 minutes from now. So we'll be going on both fields. And the new pitcher is William Andrade. Kahalu gets drilled first pitch, and now the bases are loaded.
Be a little jitters right off the bat. Little first pitch jitters coming in. A lot of action. Two runners on, first and third. Two outs. First time in the Little League World Series coming off the bench. Body ahead of the arm a little bit. Lets it one sail.
Now, Kumaho Akimo, who was hit by the pitch that last inning, and that one is in a little tight for ball one.
I'm good. No, hey, listen.
So they get Luke out of the game, has to feel great for Hawaii, and probably puts Louisiana back on his heels a little bit, because that doesn't happen very often.
Yes, got to be tough when you get your star player coming in, and the guy that one of the best players you've probably ever seen on a baseball field gets knocked around for a four spot in the first.
And now you're behind 3-0 with nowhere to put Akimo.
No strikes.
We got Gavin Berry in left field, Dara's in center, Roussel is now in right on a 3-0, and there's a strike. Luke's gone to third, Stan Wilt stays at shortstop. Connor Parrott's at first, Derek Delotti at second. Egan Prather goes to the bench. And this one to left field, back going Berry, he's under it and makes the play. And that'll do it. They'll leave the bases loaded. So a nice job after falling behind 3-0 by William Andrade. He gets out of it. It's 4-1.
First team from New Orleans ever to play in Williamsport, the Little League World Series. Man, go get them. Take no prisoners. Come home with the trophy. We're excited. We'll be following you guys.
What's up, East Bank Little League, River Ridge, Louisiana. Congratulations for making it to the Little League World Series. You guys don't understand. That was my childhood dream. You guys are living the childhood dream. So proud of you guys. Best of luck in Williamsport. Man, we're going to be rooting for you.
Pretty good. You know, you're 11 years old, and Drew Brees is saying, you're living my childhood dream.
I just was noticing earlier, a bunch of these kids in their bios, it's Drew Brees, their favorite player, and why not, from Louisiana? What a stud he is.
There's a lot of demands. Only Rossi knows what that's like. We've got Sharpie out there, kids from New Jersey, Mid-Atlantic region winners.
You signed more autographs than I did after the last game we went down there.
Yeah, you ran and hid, though. I mean, you were like, you were looking for some form of nourishment.
They were looking for Fowdy is who they were looking for.
There's a bunt, third baseman's bare hands, throws to first to high, but he holds the bag. Akimo and Kalaleha make a nice play. Review.
Nice charge here by Akimo. Couldn't decide whether he's going to go glove. Gets it a little deep, and that's where the ball goes up, and it looks pretty clear he's out there. If he keeps his foot on the bag, bare hand is the key to that play. Didn't touch his glove. These kids have done a great job not patting their glove for that extra step.
Here's Reese Roussel. He flew out to left his first time up. And he swings at the first pitch. I mean, clearly the difference here, he got some quick innings going for Louisiana at the plate, and Hawaii at the plate, Julie, takes a little bit longer. Let's get some more from Miss Fowdy.
Yeah, Carl, I'm here with Marshall Luke's mom, Carmen, his younger brother, Maddox. And Carmen, I know these last few years have been a tough few years. Can you explain that with Maddox?
It's been rough. Back in 2016, Maddox was diagnosed with cancer, Wilms tumor, which is a form of kidney cancer. Since then, he's been through multiple rounds of chemo, radiation, and just recently, he just had a stem cell transplant. Where he was his own donor, so he got his own cells, and he is doing great. Really, really good.
And how special to be here. Maddox plays himself. You guys are, of course, such huge baseball fans to be here at the Little League World Series.
It's awesome. I mean, we just came in right before the game, and to see it in person is amazing.
Hey, Maddox, what did you tell your brother who's up to bat? What advice did you give him as a baseball player?
That he's a bot.
No. What did you say? He was a bot, which is in Fortnite means he's not a great Fortnite player. What about for baseball advice? That's a good one.
That to play well and hit a home run.
Well, maybe he's going to take your advice right now, Maddox. We'll see. Hey, Maddox. Maddox, what's been the best part about being here?
Come on, boy, you got this, buddy. Let's go.
That you could roll down the hill.
We're going to get to that. We will do that.
We are going to get to that hill, I'm sure. Maddox, we're proud of you, buddy. Great to see you here.
Thank you.
Keep fighting, Maddox. This one is not going to leave the yard. It is a sky-high pop-up from the shortstop. Ransom Hung is underneath it. It's amazing how both Marshall and Maddox inspire each other. They both look up to each other. Maddox looks up to Marshall, and Marshall understands that he's playing a game of baseball, and all that gives you context on an out, a bad pitching performance. You look over at your little brother and realize what he's dealing with, and you're like, this is nothing.
Yeah, a bad game, and you go home and see that. That's putting it in perspective pretty fast for you, and playing for your little brother's got to be special, and you can tell they've got a tight relationship because him giving Maddox a heart, or him giving Marshall a hard time, you know, telling me he's a bot in Fortnite. Pretty funny.
Connor Parrott.
Ball.
So Luke out of the game already. 31 pitches. Very efficient so far for Jaron Pasquale. Nice Louisiana bats in the third.
Ball.
Now behind 3-0.
They're taking your advice, Carl. Seeing some more pitches. Reese Roussel, great swing for that base hit to right.
That was a shot.
That was a línea.
Parrott singled his first time up. Looks at a call strike on the outside corner. So Honolulu last year, Eva Beach a couple years ago. Attempting to follow in the footsteps of prior Little League World Series champions. That one gets by and it goes to the backstop. Roussel will hold at second, but all of a sudden now Louisiana in business, tying run coming to the plate.
Gavin Berry coming to the plate, one of their faster runners. See what the coach has to say.
Here we go. Here we go. Hey, don't lose focus. Okay, don't lose focus, man, on first and second. Yeah? Easiest bag can make the play, yeah? Man, on first and second. Refocus, reset. Okay, we got two outs, okay? JJ, just throw strikes, let the defense work. Yeah? Yeah? Hey, breathe. Make sure you breathe. Know where you're gonna go with the ball before the ball is hit. Know where you're gonna go with the ball before the ball is hit. Okay? Play good defense, let's get out of this inning. Here we go, 1D.
I mean, that calmed me down. Like, that was nice, right? Like, a nice, calm message. Speaking to the kids, focus, know where you're going to go. Nice, calm voice, breathe, and stay focused. Great message.
So Gavin Berry will step in. Got to check his pockets for money because he discovered when he dropped a dollar in there a couple weeks ago, it worked. Good luck. So he's carrying some cash around with him. And that one misses.
Like a wallet in his right back pocket.
Fan of the Saints, Drew Brees, Sean Payton, and this one is to second base, and a good read there. Imamura went back, said, nope, I'm good right here. They'll strand two, and Hawaii heads to the bottom of the third, leading this one by 3-4-1. Dancing here during that break. We are at the Little League World Series. Kind of contagious. You see one person move, they get a little music going, and you just start bopping around.
Great DJ here at the Little League World Series every year. As well in the truck. I'm feeling it.
Crowd that has been building all day. Dave, still one more game here at Lomity, a game underway. over at Volunteer on an ideal Friday for baseball here in Williamsport. Hawaii ideally up 4-1, bottom three. Ooh, took a little something off that one to Kaden Miyake Matsubayashi.
Nice.
Thank you. And he tried to sneak a little cheddar by him, and he was all over it. Fouled that one down the line and right.
Yeah, William Andrade, he's got the curveball we didn't see last time when he came in. He had nowhere to put him. Dumps that in for the first pitch, and then makes that fastball look even harder. That's why he saw Kaden late on that pitch.
So you opted to go with Kaden instead of Miyake Matsubayashi. I noticed you went with the first name.
Why are you calling me out, Carl?
No, I didn't. I just noticed that you did that.
I mean, you're the professional here. Kaden rolled off the tongue a little easier.
Stan Wills. Nope. The ball kind of got eaten up by that grass, a slow roller.
But a jam shot there. Stan Wills had to come in running. Marshall Luke almost cut him off from third base, but I don't think he could have made that play. That's a tough one.
Here's our guy, Caleb Chai. And that's a foul ball. Luke was there, and he would have made the play, but it's just foul.
That arm strength, he definitely would have made that play. Jeez.
Could have read the Little League on the ball before he threw it. Caleb Honorable wants to be a firefighter, just like his dad when he gets to be older. Dad was a firefighter for 32 years, going to be retiring soon. And congratulations to his dad. Dad Derek, the fire captain.
Favorite player, Jose Altuve. Another Astro. It's fun to watch.
Chai misses and he is struck out. The president of his grade level. You know what the slogan is for Caleb Chai? Don't be shy, vote for Chai.
I like it, Caleb.
Yes, sir.
They say he's a great speaker.
Shiloh Gilliland, another substitute player. A little off-speed action this inning from William Andrade.
Andrade's got that working nicely. Throwing the fastball, spreading it around. That breaking ball has really come into play this inning.
There it is again. That's in there for a strike. Our guy Shiloh Gilliland at 5'7", 140 will not eat breakfast on game day. Says he's not hungry and more focused on the game. Where's your head on that?
That's called nerves. Is what we call those. Definitely been there.
Ooh. You good, man? You good? You all right? Yeah.
Gilliland gets hit. He goes down to first. Once again, Hawaii got base runners on. The journey to the Little League World Series starts in T-ball. We all know that. We've all seen that. Visit littleleague.org/T-ball to learn how to give the youngest Little Leaguers the opportunity to have fun and learn the game.
When they send the ice cream up here?
7 o'clock game.
Okay, so I thought it might be the night.
It's the tweener game. You haven't even had dinner yet.
I had 37 Chick-fil-A sandwiches. I think I'm good.
You big order guy, like you have to have sort of your appetizer, then your meal, then your ice cream.
No.
Does it matter what order you go with?
No. Life's short. Eat dessert first, right?
Go sweet or go home.
Nice pitch.
Caleb Mathias, who's the number 9 hole hitter, had a ringing double his first time up. Got a chance to add to this 4-1 lead. They describe themselves, Rossi, as contact hitters. Would you say that's a pretty apt description?
Man, I was just thinking. I mean, when you talk about Caleb Mathias down here at the bottom of the order and the nice swing he has from the left side, we saw the double, but just contact, Beautiful swing. They got a great approach as a team. It's hard, and talking about the guy they facing in Marshall Luke and how hard he threw. I mean, this team came out swinging it. They saw pitches, a lot of 0-2 counts, and they battled back to 3-2 and got big hits.
Matthias been playing ball. We just talked about T-ball since he was four. Off-speed pitch popped up left field. Gavin Berry's there, and there is the out.
We said it already, but the first 11 swings they took in this game against Luke, they made contact and put that ball in play. I mean, that's hard to do.
Two men down, back to the top for Isaac Imamura. Something you can do. When did you learn to hit velocity? Like, were you ever intimidated, like the first guy you saw who threw it really hard?
I think Timmy talked about it earlier. I was always scared to get hit with a ball a little bit when you were young, and once you got over that fear, then it really didn't matter. You kind of timed them up, but you always thought velocity, and you were scared that they may let one go and hit you, but I don't know that I ever thought about it too much.
Fielded the flip to the pitcher covering. Nice job there by Parent and Andrade. Hawaii with a donut. We got donuts on the board. We got ice cream in a cup.
Now we're talking.
You want some swirl?
Now we're talking. Sprinkles on that, please.
We're playing for the tie, or are we losing today? Foul pull. Down the right field line as we now see Lamadi Stadium. And Louisiana trailing Hawaii by a score of 4-1. We're in the top of the fourth inning. And again, when you get a six-inning game and you get a pitcher that is doing the job that Jaron Pascual is doing, it gets a little challenging as we meet the players. Brought to you by Chick-fil-A. Say hello to Marley Sebastian. His favorite player is Mookie Betts. Big Bob Marley fan. He plays wide receiver in flag football. Favorite trip to his Arizona. And Julie's with his dad, Derek.
I am with his dad. And Carl, as you know, Derek, you don't know this yet, but we scour the bio for fun little nuggets.
Oh, okay.
And we noticed, of course, that Marley is a big Bob Marley fan. And then we tried to put the two together, and we're like, huh, you're a musician. So what is Marley named after, I wonder?
He's named after Bob Marley.
Okay.
Yeah, he's after, and we have an oldest. His name is Santana, Carlos Santana. So
right.
He has Santana, Marley, and then our youngest is Jackson, after Michael Jackson.
Yeah. So, and I feel like there's a dog in there somewhere.
There is a dog, and Marley named the dog, and his name is Ziggy.
Oh, of course. Of course it's Ziggy. And you're a musician who plays, actually, the national anthem at Major League Baseball games. Congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, I've been very blessed to do it and get to, you know, live my childhood dream, not playing sports, but playing music for sports,
you know. And now you get to live Marley's dream by being here as well.
Yeah, this is amazing. This is like surreal. You know, this is every kid's dream to be out here and to see this and your own child being out here and living his dream. And I mean, it's an emotional roller coaster, to be quite honest. So,
yeah,
but yeah, you guys make it happen. So, yeah.
All right, Derek, we're gonna get you on that ukulele for one of these national anthems, I think, while we're here.
Thank you, Julie. I appreciate it. Yeah,
right.
Take care.
Enjoy.
Love to see that, Julie. Thank you very much. Just the way that Derek talks, you can see the Marley influence there. Kind of laid back.
Almost a great play there by Marley from right field, throwing out Delat at first base on that base hit. Had a nice throw, got behind it. Always seems like the kids do something when we start talking to their parents.
To their parents, right. Jeffrey Curtis pops this one foul.
Here we go, man.
This was close. I would think you would advise Delat to just run through the bag, right? Not slide into it.
Yeah. It's a little bit nice pick there at first base. Almost.
Shallow right fielder with good arms out there, and the ball gets to him quick. You got a chance there. This is Jeffrey Curtis.
Jules, I want to know where he got that hat. That was a legit bucket hat. That's what I wear to golf in. So
what was that?
I want to know where he got the dad got that hat.
Oh,
that was nice. I got to check the gift shops for that.
That will be. Then I'll get the investigative reporting prize.
We do give that after each Little League World Series. So Julie's in line. And Kirkshin's bucking for that too.
And the dance. And we're definitely going to see the worm and the floss from Jules.
Curtis, shallow left. Who's got this one? Good hustle over there from Logan Kulalea. Ball hung up a little bit for him, and there are two men down on two pop-outs.
Love how this Hawaii team is moving on every pitch. Everybody's backing each other up. You see the right fielder headed towards first, backing up second. Was the second baseman as the shortstop goes out. Everybody moving.
Monitor.
Oh, no, not again. All right, if you must. If I must.
It's amazing, too, how quickly people respond to you.
I mean,
what if you start asking for vehicles or other things? Is that coming up to the booth? Because food you've delivered on.
I think we're going to have a contest at the end of this thing, see how much I've eaten and see how many pounds. I'm going to have to weigh in tonight.
This one is going to be a hit. And it's a good job by the number nine hitter, Stan Wiltz. So Louisiana, second inning now in a row that they've brought the tying run to the plate. Yeah, we have it. The list is growing, which is really impressive what's going on.
Just a backup slider that runs back up and in. Nice job there, staying inside that ball, throwing it out there for a knock. This Louisiana team's got some fight to them. Good at bats.
Here's Ryan Dara, and he pops this one to right field. Sebastian is there to make the play. They threaten again, and they come up empty. Hawaii's defense has been stout since that error. They lead it 4-1, heading to the bottom of the fourth on the 10th fly ball out. After yesterday's rainout, in which we had just one game played, Curaçao beat Australia. We had all sorts of weather issues and didn't play another game, didn't throw another pitch. Today scheduled for 7 games, and already 4 of them are in the books. This is the 5th over on ESPN, the app right now. Mexico and Canada are playing, and that's the view from Volunteer. That's Lomity Stadium right there. And we're kind of panning the camera a little left, and lo and behold, you get past the Little League Grill. And there you see Volunteer Stadium. That's where they host the international bracket. And a little meeting on the mound on the first. I like the high five already because we got an issue. We got bases loaded. So we'll keep our eye on that one. And back here at Lomity, it is 4-1. Hawaii bats again. William Andrade has done a pretty good job here, kind of slowing down the Hawaii train. They scored 4 runs in the first and have now gone back-to-back innings with nothing.
I think they proved they could hit the fastball from Luke. Andrade really brought in that breaking ball, slowing them down. That's what you got to do. An aggressive team that likes to hit the fastball, a contact team like this Hawaii group, keeps continuing to put the ball in play, slow them down with that breaking ball, and he's done exactly that.
A little high to Branson Hong. He has struck out twice.
1-2, fellas.
Popped up and just onto the screen.
Ryder Plancher's begging. I know exactly what he was thinking. Come back just a little more. Been there in that situation. You start begging a little bit, Carl.
It started to. As Egan Prather, who started behind the plate, now back out throwing a baseball. He warms up. This one beaten into the ground. See if Wiltz can do this one. Oh, good arm that time. Stan Wiltz. That ball was finally hit hard enough that he could make a play on it. Little League wants to extend a special thank you to its official sponsors, T-Mobile. You should thank the next one.
And Chick-fil-A.
Of course.
There we go.
They help maintain the strength and leadership of the Little League program. And they also want to thank its dedicated volunteers who make the program a special experience for all the children. Jaron Pasquale swings at the first one and fouls it off.
Look on his face right there. He's upset he missed that breaking ball. Felt like he was right on it. See if he gets another one this at bat. Always that pitch, you feel like, ooh, I was right on that thing.
Fastball, good one there, but called the ball to even it up at 1-1. Pascal's reached twice. Single and a walk, scored. That's hit hard. Nice job over there by Marshall Luke. Stayed down on it. That ball was hit hard, and the third baseman gets the out.
Made that play look really easy. Marshall Luke, this ball is smoked. right to third base, stays on it, just moves his feet, nice easy throw to first base. Textbook. Nice shuffle through your target. Jeez, he's smooth.
Right back to the pitcher, and a good inning for William Andrade. It looked like he was coming out. Still shy of that 35 pitch count. Hawaii is up 4-1 through 4. New Jersey just chilling right now as they get set for their game coming up at 7 o'clock Eastern time. Our Honda game summary, Hawaii leading Louisiana by a score of 4-1. The winner of this one gets the winner of our night game tonight, New Jersey and Oregon. 10 of the 12 outs have been flyouts. Hawaii has been great when it comes to making contact. And that one is caught in the air, and Reese Roussel is retired. They continue to be aggressive at the plate, Rossi.
Yeah, they're swinging away. It's kind of a totally different approach than Hawaii's taken. They've hit some balls hard early on, making some solid contact just right at them. And this Hawaii defense has played really good as well.
I think Marshall Luke's ready to do some big damage. I think we're going to have a home run here.
We got a call.
Ball one to Luke, who had himself an outstanding regional tournament, both on the mound and at the plate. No homer, but he hit it hard into left field, and it gets by the left fielder. So Luke sprints to second. He's going to go to third base.
Up, 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 up.
On the base, he is in there. Marshall Luke hit it hard.
You had that good feeling, Carl. And I thought after he hit it so hard and it got by, I thought we might have it inside the park. Homer, nice swing. That was loud. Long strides. And then he turns it on right there, rounding first base. That's a big kid making it look easy rounding those bases for a triple.
They've had a lot of traffic. You think if they could just get one across, change the mood on that bench. Connor Perrin.
Guess that's a base hit with a two-base error, but you know what I mean.
I felt you. Absolutely. I know. You're supporting your guy. Every step along the way, from the districts to the states, the regional tournament, it gets a little more difficult. And this Louisiana team has not had it easy, but they've won all their games. And they've scored a lot of runs, and they run into this Hawaii team. And I'm sure when you get your bracket and you see, like, Hawaii, you're like, wow, they've won a lot. They're all going to be good, but that's a really good team and a tough draw in your first game. Foul ball. Luke did a good job to get out of the way of it.
Good lesson there. Run the bases in foul territory just in case you do get hit. You won't be out. Watch this ball here, Luke. Headed to watch your lips. Nice athleticism.
Tough play there. You're trying to get out of the way of it. If, in fact, feet are off the bag and you get hit by it and it's fair, you're going to be out. So that's a hard play.
Good take. Connor Parrott there taking that breaking ball down after that fastball in. Coach telling him, stay up the middle. Need to get this run in if they got a shot.
Single and a walk for Parrott. On the corner, nasty pitch and a good one from Jaron Pascual. That's a perfect pitch, Rossi.
That's a pitcher's pitch. Fastball down and away. This ball is paint. After that breaking ball, try to see it up, and that ball is just money. That's exactly where you want it as a catcher, coming right at you down and away. Toughest pitch to hit in baseball to me, that fastball well located down and away.
Got a one next to that K. Only the first strikeout by Louisiana today.
Hey, Carl, I know you were talking earlier about the East Bank Little League softball team making it to the title game. Well, these guys here on East Bank Little League's baseball team wanted to actually hit some of their pitchers. And so they said, hey, Kayla Giardina, could we maybe try and hit you? And the coaches of East Bank Little League baseball team said, that's a bad idea. Very bad idea. And I said to them before the game, hey, how'd it go? And they said, really bad.
Yes.
It was indeed a bad idea. And Gavin Berry, our boy up right now, actually was one who stood up, was courageous enough to stand up to him. in the batter's box, and he struck out.
Rossi, you know that every baseball player who goes and faces these softball pitchers, they have no chance.
None. Zero. That's coming in hot from a close proximity. Here it is.
And from an angle you're just not used to. Good luck.
I mean, he wasn't even ready. That was so late.
Gavin Berry, right field, slipping, now coming in, and he won't get it. Is Marley Sebastian. Big second run comes across, and a tough effort out there for Sebastian. He lost his footing.
Nice at bat by Gavin Berry. They needed that run with two outs. Battling here, tough play in right by Marley. Just loses his feet right at the last second here. Trying to keep his eyes head low on it, and just as it runs out of glove, falls down a little early, just out of his reach. Carl, that video took me back. Remember when Jenny Finch went around and just was punching tickets all over the major leagues? That was fun to watch.
Egan Prather now with a chance. Tying run at the plate.
Ball.
Comfortable swing from Prather.
I like Prather's swing. Each at bat, he's had some really good swings. Highly competitive, as coaches say. Catcher loves Gary Sanchez.
So the other catcher, Duke Aloy, is doing a heck of a job back there behind home plate. Making sure that ball doesn't get to the backstop.
It'll be a good blocker when there's a ditch behind you. You got to go get it.
2-1. Framed it, 2-2. Nicholas Nishiwa warming for Hawaii out there in the Hawaii bullpen, number 8.
Pasquale's got that nice angle when it's down the way. Tough for right-handed hitters.
Big pitch. Prather, right field. That's hit hard. Right at Sebastian, though. It took a few steps back, and he's able to make the play and make him feel good about what happened. Heading to the bottom of the fifth, Hawaii's lead has been reduced by 1. 7 o'clock Eastern time. Our coverage starts 5:30 Eastern. Baseball Tonight, Sunday Night Countdown on ESPN and the ESPN app. Nicholas Nishiwa just went from warming up in the bullpen to the plate. Slow off-speed in there for a strike. There's a lot of stuff going on with teams. Now they're scouting. They got video of all the regionals. And we thank everybody that spent some time watching the regionals this year on ESPN and elsewhere.
Ball.
But is there something you can take from the way that Hawaii managed to hit the fastball and has struggled a little bit against some of this off-speed stuff?
Well, I think that's what I would notice. First of all, you got one of the hardest throwers in this tournament.
That guy, Luke.
And Luke throwing across the diamond. And they were all over every pitch, taking them, timing them up, fouling balls off, putting them in play. And then you look at what William Andrade's been able to do. Slow him down with the breaking ball. If I'm scouting this game and watch this Hawaii team, you would think a little bit I might have to get a soft throwing guy with a breaking ball or some great off speed. Because they definitely make great contact.
A phenomenal job, dude. Great job. Hey, kept this right here, buddy. It's awesome. Awesome. Way to go, Will. Great job, Will. Let's go. Go get him.
Great smile as he comes off. William Andrade did a terrific job. And now they're going to turn it over to 2-4. Ethan Prather, who started as the catcher. He's on the mound when we return to the Little League World Series. Now at Sports Center, they'll be dancing tonight. Kenny Mayne, big-time dancer. He was on Dancing with the Stars first, wasn't he?
Kenny Mayne, yes.
Yeah. So he's in the studio tonight with Nabil Kareem. They'll have the latest on the wild card races. Did Daniel Jones do against the Bears? Team USA can take away from their tune-up against Spain. Sports Center 10 Eastern on ESPN and the ESPN app. Following Little League Baseball. Bottom 5. Hawaii would like to add a couple. against the new pitcher, Egan Prather. You see his numbers in the Southwest Regional. Big swing and a miss from Logan Kulaloya.
Another great athletic catcher that takes another position, Carl.
I know. Back up the middle, hit hard, and there's no chance for Stan Wiltz on that. Kulaloya is 2-for-2 today.
That's what this Hawaii team does well. They stay on that fastball. Prather trying to get that 0-2 fastball by him, and he was ready.
Duke Aloy singled, struck out. Ball is into left off the end of the bat, so it didn't go nearly as far as I think Barry thought it was going to go. And a couple of balls in play, and you got two men on. Sounded a little more impressive, I think, than it traveled.
Yeah, I think that, you know, you get fooled as an outfielder. The ball's off the bat, especially in the line drive area. You want your first reactions to break back, and can't tell when it goes off the end. Pretty good loud noise.
This is Marley Sebastian now. Take a look at the swing, where it hit the bat.
There's a 4D camera we've got. I love this view. Watch the contact. We go all the way around. That is just textbook again. Back knee bent, front leg, head behind. That's beautiful.
We got time.
Bottom third of this order, 6, 7, 8, 9 have been outstanding. Rossi, 6-for-9, 3 RBIs. This is the we is better than the me thing. A lot of teams have echoed that.
Well, that's what this Hawaii team has preached, is that they're a well-rounded group. Coach Brad Long has talked about every man is going to contribute, and that has been the day, with what we've seen here today.
That's in there, 0-2 now, Marley Sebastian. It's the big shutdown inning for East Bank. Trying to keep this at 2 with one more at bat. And trying to blow a fastball by him.
We're going to change that now. We're going to change that.
They are all over the heater when it comes in there.
Prather peeks out from the top of his glove, fires one in. And it's fouled off. It's great to see, isn't it? No matter you're watching it, Volunteer, Lomity, wherever the kids come from, for the most part, the mechanics, the fundamentals are just all there.
They are, and it impressed me every year, the fundamentals and how good they are at this age.
Off speed, Sebastian retired. That's a big out.
There's that big breaking ball we were talking about. Coming off that fastball up that he fouled straight back to pitch before. Just this 12-6. You see right there, nice finish on it. Starts up right down the middle. Beautiful breaking ball from Prather.
Got to be careful. This is a good hitter. Caleb Mathias. Double flew out to left. On that one, and this one is to the gap, and it gets down. Mathias will bring in the run from second, Kulaleo, and that's a big run. Caleb Mathias out of the 9 spot, Rossi, really good hitter.
We talked about it, a lot of great swings from Mathias today. Caleb on this, jumps all over this first pitch and stays inside it. We talked about good hitters get jammed. He is inside this baseball, into his legs, balls off the kind of handle of the bat, just throws it out to left field. He has got a beautiful swing for the 9-hole hitter. Big hits today.
Imamura, line shot. Wiltz is there. He catches it in the air, and that'll do it. But they do tack on that 5th run, and it's a big one. Pasquale's going to come back on the mound. He's got some pitches to play with, and he's got a 3-run lead.
This is what great moments are about, right? Hey, believe in yourselves to give yourself a chance to come back in this game. All right? Hey, believe in yourselves. Hey, positive mental attitude. We've not had much PMA in this game. All right? Hey, it's not too late to change it. All right? So believe in yourselves here. Give yourselves a chance. We're going to have a chance. So believe it's going to happen. All right? Positive mental attitude. All right? Come on, one at a time. One at a time. Let's go.
Starting to think that we should have, like, maybe Tex, get a Tex detail. Maybe Tex should provide some type of furniture that these kids can actually sit on prior to their game, because we're just lounging on some cement down there.
Yeah, it's not real cool. They got the backpacks kicking, they're all waving. Yep, you're on TV, ESPN.
You guys know David Ross, pretty BD, big deal.
I tell you what, this is the most beautiful thing we're watching. That hill is nice.
This is your favorite time of day, isn't it? You like when it goes from sun to a little
shade,
dusk, get the nighttime going, lights are on. One pitch, one out. Two outs away from getting the win here is Hawaii. Find the Little League on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, at the official handles at Little League. Follow the action, join the conversation with hashtag LLWS.
You know how we do Sunday from the seats for ESPN and the major leagues? We should do one game from out there. You ever done one around there?
We have.
Oh, darn.
Guilty. We've been out there.
I wasn't a part of it then. Darn it.
Sat on a chair and did it from like left center field.
Was it fun?
It was kind of cool. I would say that. It was kind of cool. It was cold that night. Mike Notaro, of course, our crack researcher here, just writes down, was cold. He sat out there shivering. I don't have that recollection. I recall it as just a wonderful event. And you, freezing,
yeah,
shivering.
Where's your positive mental
PMA
attitude
on that?
Yeah, that's brutal.
Totally brutes.
Talking about really good. Jaren Pascual has been in command.
Ball.
He's looking to go complete game. He's just thrown 71 pitches. You get 85 before you have to be taken out. One thing about the West region teams, they tend to have kids who either haven't pitched at the regionals show up and just dominate. And you're like, wow, they got another one. They have a lot of pitching. Over the years, teams from the West, California, traditionally, like, wait, we haven't seen that lefty, and he comes in and just throws nothing but power strikes.
Ball.
Good at bat from Peyton. Having to go 0-2, 3-2. They need base runners here. That tack-on run from Hawaii last inning really is going to hurt them. Got to get a good at bat here from Peyton. Get on base if they got any kind of chance.
Significance of that first game is huge since they expanded this field from 8 to 16. Every World Series champion won their first game.
Nice at bat.
Base on ball for Spadoni. Peyton Spadoni down to first. That's Stan Wills, the shortstop bat. And then it's back to the top of the order. So barring a double play, we'll get back to the top of the order. And Wiltz has reached base. He's one for one. And he swings at the first pitch and fouls it onto the concourse here. It never occurred to me that when the ball goes on the roof, does it actually fall over the other side, or is there a wall there to catch it?
It's a good question. A lot of kids down there.
I would think there's a wall, right?
Yeah.
I think there's something to catch the ball.
They've thought of everything here, I feel like.
Yeah.
There's our answer.
There you go. Thank you, Doug Holmes, our director. Where don't we have cameras?
I was just about to ask. There's our home away from home up there.
Beyond that fence, heavily guarded. Wilt strikes out, one out away is Hawaii. Awfully impressive. You mentioned it, Jaren Pascual.
He has just been in control, smooth, no emotion, executing pitch after pitch.
Dara, line shot. That one gets through, and it goes to center field. And the brakes are on, and now all of a sudden we got back to the top of the order, and the tying run is at the plate. Good piece of hitting. Ryan Dara does not waste any time. Four at bats, and he has faced four pitches.
Yeah, and he's made contact on every one. You see here, a little bit of a meeting.
We'll find out what Brad Lung is going to do.
Hey, you wait for your pitch. Make sure you don't pull off.
Okay, we have two outs, man, on first and second. We can go easy as bag, okay? Get your breathing. Breathe into your nose, out your mouth. Relax yourself. Slow down your heart rate, okay? You guys playing a very good game right here, okay? We need to talk to our outfielders. We cannot have anything go over their heads. They need to get the ball in quickly, okay? We have a lead, okay? Focus on what we came here to do. Focus on what we came here to do. You guys understand? Play within yourself. Don't lose yourself. We're in the moment right now. Play in the moment. Play solid defense, okay? You guys got that? Okay, here we go. Focus.
Last year, the coaches and the manager from Honolulu, similar approach, similar message, became stars in their own right. And Brad Lung is off to a terrific start in the way he delivers his messages.
And I like how he takes a little bit of the momentum, slows the moment down with coming off that hit and taking the fans out of it.
Here's Reese Roussel. First pitch, ball one. Outfield is very deep all around. And they are all baked in the sunshine right now. Sebastian in right, Matthias and Kulalea from right to left. Roussel, oh, he hammered it, but he pulled it foul. Ooh, that was close.
That ball was hammered.
Everybody got up and checked where that one was going.
We got a long at bat to go, Mom. Come on, lock back in.
Brandy was up on her feet. Coaches were moving. Here's the next one. And that one's in the dirt. And Marshall Luke is on deck. So if that one kind of got to Jaron Pasquale, and I was going to be careful, load him up and be in real trouble against the next guy. To one, hammered off the glove of the first baseman, and everybody is safe and they are loaded. Now the throw to third, and it doesn't get by, but wow, Louisiana striking back.
They're starting to feel their swing. That was an absolute rocket to first base from Roussel. This team's starting to feel their momentum. They've got their stud up here. Roussel gets a head out again. Tough play there for Nakia. But we got bases loaded and the star player for Louisiana up.
Marshall Luke, look out. Hit two home runs in the regional.
This will be Jaron Pasquale's last hitter at 83 pitches. Can't go over 85.
Swing and a drive, center field, and it is caught in center field by Caleb Matthias. And that ends a terrific Little League World Series game. Hawaii hangs on and wins it 5-2. Pascal goes the distance. Disappointment for Louisiana, but I don't think that's the last we're going to hear from Louisiana.
That team can hit. They finally started to feel it there at the end. Seeing Pasquale run out of gas a little bit. Some good at-bats there at the end from Louisiana. Really made this a game. Loading them up. That's all you can ask for. Don't quit. Coach is telling about a positive attitude right now. Talking to them and keeping their heads up. That was a well-played game with really two great teams going at it.
I'm feeling pretty good if I'm Scott Frazier, too. And I asked for a positive attitude. And I loaded them up and brought our home run hitter up to the plate.
No doubt.
Well done. 14 of the 18 outs, Rossi, were fly ball outs. And that guy was the star, Jaron Pasquale.
Preaching launch angle.
He got into it here. Another good start for a Hawaii team looking to do what so many of their predecessors recently have done, which is win the United States and overall Little League World Series title.
Great game from Caleb Matthias down at the nine hole. Really some really big hits, some key hits for them. And just Hawaii jumping out early on that first inning, jumping on Luke on that fastball. A lot of base hits and some big hits after an error.
So we've had Virginia win 3-0, Minnesota a 2-1 winner. Those two teams will be off until Sunday. Rhode Island will take on Kentucky tomorrow. Louisiana will play tomorrow against the loser of the New Jersey-Oregon game. Hawaii will be on the field Sunday in front of the